Okay, hello guys, and what is up? This is Silence Pew Pew, and we're coming at you guys with another video. Guys, today we are going to be playing Farming Simulator 19 yet again. This is part of our Let's Play series. If you haven't, go check out video 1 to understand how we got here. I recommend checking out video 1 for just a few reasons, because you'll see the pieces of equipment that we bought and how we took this farm and made it $1 million. Yep, the farm is worth technically about $1 million if I sold all of the equipment. Anywho, so today, guys, basically just give you an overview of what we're going to be doing is we're going to be probably planting a few more trees and cutting down a few more trees. Not really anything too exciting. I'm going to show you guys just basically the interesting things. I'll show you a little bit of me cutting down some trees again, maybe some me planting some stuff, buying stuff, and then how much we get, how much we can sell it for if we have time today to sell stuff. So here we go. As we talked about in the first video, if you haven't watched, I definitely recommend going and checking out. We should own these trees back here. We're going to open up this harvester. This isn't too big of a tree, but you know, that's fine. We don't need big trees necessarily. I mean, the bigger they are, the easier it is, less work you gotta do, but you know, that's fine. No big deal. Now, this game, to anything like 2017, which I predict it's gonna be very similar, probably not exactly like, but you know, trees take approximately. Sometimes it looks turn up, sometimes it doesn't. I don't know why this is not turning. I'm completely off the ground. Still won't let us turn up. I guess we'll just cut it here. Yeah. Close enough. It's on the pile. Anyways, like I said, guys, if you wanted to harvest this stuff, I believe that's in there. Sometimes. put that. Anyways, guys, it's gonna be one of those moments where we get to fast forward here, because literally all it's gonna be is just us driving the train back and forth through this mile here for a bit. Do a few more trees here, and then hopefully that'll be enough to get a load going. Anyways, guys, like I said, we're gonna keep this actually in one play. I said that last game, one speed for a bit, just because we don't want our cost of payments going up too quickly here. Now I know that it's based more on the hours. But basically that loan payment, we don't want that coming out yet. We don't want that coming out for a while. So because I think it's gonna be like $5,000, which is literally half of our money right now. Which is way more than we can afford. Because we need to still rent a truck. Pull all this wood, so I think it's right around 10,000. We'll be close to the price. Like I said, once you get the hang of the machine here, it's quick. You need to switch very quickly. You get quite perfect on that pile there, but that's, it doesn't need to be perfect. It just needs to be close, that way I don't have to chase down logs and stuff like that. If you had two people, honestly, two people for logging, I think it's right around the perfect amount. More than that, helps, but two people is really ugly. So if you have a friend, recommend it. Two of you can go and do a lot of things. Honestly, I recommend two people from the team. The only one that you wouldn't really need two people for is dealing with animals. But, you know, cats. I mean, it depends on what you're doing. If you're just, you know, buying the stuff from the store, you really don't. I'll get a stump cutter come in here and cut all those stumps away. For now, we don't need them. We will, though, let them start harvesting that field. But that's why we got three nice fields here. Big open area, too. We could plant so many trees here, honestly. We're just not going to, you know. We're just going to plant them on the field. perfect. The pile's not perfect, but it's close enough. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, I think that is almost it. I'm gonna go grab one or two more trees here, and then we'll catch back. You'll catch back up with me when I grab the really few trees. I'll show you the size of the pile, and then we'll start using the wheel loader here. Or not, that's not the wheel loader. Actually, that was how you guys feel about the whole automatic engine start, automatic thing? I like it. Interesting. I did get used to the other one though, where I just got it turned on and how the vehicle turned off. So as you can see, there's a lot of stuff here actually. I haven't even tried to use this thing yet. It's not terrible, but... Well, I mean, at least all the weights in the back is an interesting thing. I've never seen one quite like this where it's got, like, hydraulics and turn it, basically. So at this point now, we're gonna actually have to go to the store and buy a truck. So what we're gonna do is, I guess we're gonna save. Check the time. We're gonna go to the store, like I said, there we go. Now, we don't really need, like, the best truck here. I mean, that one would be nice, but we don't need it. We don't need 620 horsepower. 460 should be enough, I would think. Look at that, $9,000. Okay, so I kind of want to change the color, but, I mean, it's just... Like, it's just $3,000. Holy cow. It doesn't increase the initial price by much, but let's see here. Per hour operation. Wow. 6,000. Whoopsies, I didn't mean to buy it. So I just realized there was a slight echo. My bad, guys. I hope that wasn't being picked up in the mic as well. If so, that was probably really annoying, and maybe you might not have even been able to hear me. I hopefully just fixed that, but oh, that raises it by like $150. Let's not do it though, just because we don't need it. I mean, I wasn't necessarily gonna go with that color, but keep... Alright, we're gonna lease that. Okay, pick up from the store. What should we get, like, more customization? You know, like, I know it's a lizard with a truck. Yeah. I've also found that out. The horns on tractor trailers will be big monster trucks. I don't know why, but their horns are not loud. I think it's just for your, kind of, thing. I mean, I don't know if you want to do this for much. Seems out of time. Alright, not bad. I'll take it. Nice thing though about this one is 2015 didn't have straps. 2017 had straps. And 2019 had straps as well. Definitely a bonus there. Had those straps. 2015 when I played that one, you just had to drive really, really careful. Now the straps still work a little goofy, but overall they're nice. And when I teleport the car. basically. Back it up just like this, basically. And then we're gonna go pretty much straight this way. Alright, so we're basically gonna get max stretch for all of this stuff here. All of my... Okay, we're on. So, actually, I'm not getting them up there perfectly, but as you can see, like, right about here is halfway. So it looks like 6 meters is about right. If I had these more up this way, I think most of them would be good. But I'm just like, let's see that there, you know that. So, we're not quite in the perfect spot. We didn't park that truck perfectly. So, alright guys, anyways, we're back now. We got this all loaded here. We're missing one log. I can't get it. But we got this here set up. Unfortunately, this one kind of slid out the back. It's still strapped in, so it'll stay here, but just so you guys know that. Next time, what we're going to do, actually, is we're going to put down, like, two logs. Like, one here and then one here, so that way my forks can get underneath of the pile. I don't know why I didn't think of that originally. Basically, we just need something that's going to get me that grip, initially. So, I'm going to go ahead and help you around, and we will catch you guys as soon as we're at the mill where we sell all these logs here. I'm willing to bet we can get right around 15, anywhere between 10 and $15,000, which isn't great, but it's not horrible. I know it's on the other end of the map, but I don't remember how to get there. Okay, so if we are there, we need to get there. Should just stay on that main road, get to the shop, and then turn over. Alright guys, so here we are. I went ahead and unfastened all the belts just because when you sell them all, the belts stay fastened, they all like suck down. Sometimes they get glitched out and stay up on top where there is nothing. But as you can see, this is all of them here. It's not too terrible of a drive, so over here is where you have to sell them at, and our farm is over here. It's basically almost the furthest drive you can go, except from here, you know, the whole way up to here, but there's nothing to sell over here. I mean, we could have to drive for that one. It's not terrible. It's mostly flat. There's a little bit of uphills. Not too bad, though. Truck made it just fine. No problem. So here we are. We're at $1,300. We're going to sell, like I said, $15,000. That's what I told you it'd be about. So not too bad. It's a decent amount of worth of work. However, it's definitely one of the more profitable businesses because it's very quick and easy. You just need to have trees. That's the only issue, which actually now we're going to... Now we're going to go actually and we're just going to take this thing back to the farm. We're going to shut this thing off because I've noticed that things become not much as worth it once you get to about hour 4 on leasing things. So you want to try to use things that you're leasing for about 4 hours and then you want to get rid of it. And that's at the point where you want to buy it though. So hopefully in 4 hours that thing makes you enough money to where you can just lease it. Basically, the next step that we're going to do is we are going to be planting some trees now. Anyways, guys, so I'm going to talk to you while we're driving back to the farm here, or to the shop. We're going to go pick up some more trees, and then we're going to plant them. Now, we only planted those other ones technically in-game an hour ago, so this row of trees and that row of trees won't be too far apart from each other. Unfortunately, we will need to get to a point where we need to just fast forward basically a decent amount. And that'll be coming up in the next video, actually. But we're going to get two more rows planted of trees here, and then we're pretty much going to be done. We probably will use that truck one more time, and I think we're going to end the lease with it. I don't know if I might keep it. It just kind of depends on the daily cost. I don't know what it is off the top of my head. Let's just check that out real quick. So to lease this thing, per day is $1,000. Unfortunately, though, like I said, once we get a little bit longer, the problem is we'll run out of trees that are already there. I think after we buy trees, I think we can. Any decorations? We could before. They don't want you just to buy trees and then sell them. I'll keep looking though. I'll catch up with you guys. So guys, actually, while we're here, we're gonna go ahead and actually repay like $10,000 of that loan. The reason for this, is that way at the end of the day, when this comes out, we owe less money than we would. I think it's only going to be like $50 or so. I'm not sure. I don't know. But it's not going to be a whole lot, but, you know. I figure, you know, it's better than nothing. Maybe $100. I think it might be $100. I'm not sure. Either way, though, I just save it. Seriously, decorations, that's about it. I mean, it's not in decorations, it's not in miscellaneous. Those are the two places that I would assume. I have to move in silos. I gotta go through here, yeah. I mean, it's not gonna be any of this stuff, right? All these wheel loaders, belts, I doubt it, but interesting. What the heck is this one? Alright, you guys, so here we are. We're planting these trees now. Boom, two down, maybe more to go. It's actually three rows. I thought it was only two. I don't know why. Yeah. Either way, though, pretty much is it. Like I said, though, we're going to short crops. No big deal. Guys, that is going to be it for today. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys all on